Lord Lilac thought it rather rotten that Shakespeare should be quite forgotten, and therefore got on a committee with several chaps out of the city, and Shorter and Sir Herbert Tree, Lord Rothschild and Lord Rosebery, and FCG and Common Car, two jukes and a dramatic star, also a clergyman, now dead. And while the vain world careless sped, unheeding the heroic name, the souls most fed with Shakespeare's flame still sat unconquered in a ring, remembering him like anything. Lord Lilac did not long remain. Lord Lilac did not come again. He softly lit a cigarette and sought some other social set, wherein some other knots or rings people were doing cultured things. Miss Wilt's humane vivarium, the little men that paint on gum, the exquisite gorilla girl. He sometimes, in this giddy world, not being really bad at heart, remembered Shakespeare with a start, but not with that grand constancy of Clement Shorter, Herbert Tree, Lord Rosebery and Common Car, and all the other names there are, who stuck like limpets on the spot, lest they forgot. Lord Lilac was of slighter stuff. Lord Lilac had had quite enough.